In this illustration, we'll analyze the mercury overflowing a glass flask. We are given that a glass flask of volume 1000 centimeter cube is filled with mercury at 0 degree centigrade. And when it is heated to 100 degree centigrade, 15.2 centimeter cube of mercury overflows. Now, we are given with the coefficient of cubical expansion of mercury, and we are required to find the coefficient of linear expansion of glass. In this situation, we can use the apparent expansion of mercury with respect to glass. So, we can write as mercury is filled in glass flask of volume, if we write it V0, we can write the apparent expansion of mercury with respect to flask. This concept we already studied in concept videos, that the apparent expansion of mercury with respect to flask can be given as, this we can write as delta V is equals to V naught gamma apparent multiplied by delta T. And we know here the value of gamma apparent, the apparent coefficient of expansion of mercury with respect to glass, is written as gamma of mercury minus 3 alpha of glass. So, we substitute the volume which will overflow is given to us as 15.2. The volume of a flask is 1000 multiplied by gamma apparent. We can write as gamma mercury minus 3 alpha glass. So, gamma mercury is also given to us 1.82 into 10 to power minus 4 minus 3 alpha of glass multiplied by change in temperature, which is from 0 to 100 degrees. So, we can take delta T as 100. So, when we simplify this value, the value of alpha glass we are getting is 1 by 3 times of this is 1.82 into 10 to power minus 4 minus 15.2 multiplied by 10 to power minus 5. Now, in this situation, you can rearrange the terms. This will give you the final result on simplifying this. You can see, we are getting the result is this 18.2 minus 15.2 into 10 to power 5, 3 gets cancelled out, and the result is 10 to power minus 5 degrees centigrade per inverse, and this is the result of this problem.